Hi, this is Nick here at OnlyFabs. I wanted to make a video about getting started and what does it actually cost to play Flash Mob. Is it expensive or isn't it? So the topics are going to be, is it enough to try it, to play it casually or to play it competitively? Because I know for a fact that if I want to play a TCG, well, what Flash Mob is, I want to play it eventually on a competitive level. At least enough to be possible to compete at the top level tables. You need to be good enough, but hopefully I've got something else to say about that. Getting started is, getting to try it is actually quite simple. There are pre-cons available of the Blitz decks of the current heroes that are available in Monarch. And for 12 pieces a deck, I don't think it's that expensive to try at least. So you're setting yourself 50 euros back if you want to at least play the game. You can approach it like a board game. You, if you have a buddy, you can buy four of these, you get to play them, and then you can find out if you actually like the game, if it's something you want to get involved with, and drop the higher amounts that are required to further your hobby. But yeah, it's a nice entry point, and it gets you a feel of the game, and to experience it, and what all the hype is and the fuss is all about. So, okay, I said you can spend more on this game. What would it look like? Well, you could buy a box for 80 euros, at least to play. This is beyond trying. This is more, actually, you could also for your 80 euros try it, but that's more prohibitive to actually spend 80 than maybe 50 euros. So you get one fourth of a chance at the legendary. You get 5 to 8 majestics and a bunch of rares, mostly all the commons you will need to build a deck. And this allows you also to trade. Pointed it out there for all the sets, WTR and Arcane, there are super rares. They're even cheaper. You find them more often. For the purpose of this video, just treat them as majestics that are actually cheaper, or maybe rares that are actually rarer, but they're not that more expensive. Actually, if you want to play a competitive deck, I've mostly focused here on a generic legendary for the equipment, a class legendary, which is introduced with Monarch. The talent legendary is introduced with Monarch. So you're talking about 3 legendaries for equipment. I won't say they're needed for each and every class. I'm just trying to get some numbers of a higher proportion of competitive deck. So you most likely need 2 to 4 generic majestics and 4 to 6 class majestics. And why did I mention all these majestics and not the rares and commons? Well, the rares and commons are actually really cheap. We're talking less than a euro. If you buy 2 boxes, you'll definitely have all the stuff that you need with regarding to rares and commons. Maybe you'll have to trade a couple of them, but that's like less than 10 euros if you can trade them within your local group. Okay, class, talent, legendaries, there's a big spread on them. So if you have a ninja, a mask of momentum, yeah, you can spend 200 euros. But for another top performer, Dorinthia, the gloves aren't as much required to play the deck. They only cost 130-ish, and that's in euros. I'm not saying it's cheap, I'm just saying there's a big spread. And it's not like the other decks don't perform well. They do have an underdog position, and all the competitive top 8s have been overwhelmed with Iroh, at least in Blitz. There will be a big shakeup now with Monarch launching, so we'll see how that divulges the prices. Will it be this steep line from 80 to 200, or will it stay like this, like less than 100 for super classes, at least competitively, and more than 200 for the higher end. And the generic class legendaries, they cost around 200 euros right now as well. This is with an unlimited printing. Hopefully the new increased player base will also push out more ARC and WTR and will have some downward pressure on the prices. I don't know, most players I think that play the game already have those generics. I don't know. I'm not a financial guy. I'm just stating what the current market position on these cars is. Class Majestics and generic Majestics, though, they are comparing those, the Class Majestics only perform well in your class, and they have a low price point than the generics, which are more sought after and are in every competitive deck. So they cost 40 to 50, and the other 10 to 20. So how does this total amount? Because okay, now you see the class legendaries and what's in it. Also, try to remember these numbers if you're looking at buying a box and or a case to up your chances of legendary. Because the top of the bill will put you back somewhere to 600 to 700 euros. That's why I put this sentence right there in the middle, but do you need it? The generic and the class legendaries, I think they should be last on your list. Get the Majestics first, then the generic Majestics, and then the legendaries later. Because the actual backbone of your deck are the class Majestics, but really the rainbow pitch set, so the red, yellow, and blue version of the commons and rares. Why they are quite literally what make the deck, and I've my current love right here is Chain. Yeah, these cards are really strong and they allow for some added consistency. These push it over the top, the Commander Conquerors. But what actually is a real performer in the deck and which makes it drive and tick is this one, Seeds of Agony. This is, these cards have a certain type of effect which make the deck tick, make it work, and because you can actually play more copies of those in the deck, like six copies if you have two red, two yellow, two blue, and of the Majestics you only play two copies, so the effect is six pieces of the 40 card deck versus two pieces in the 40 card deck, so you see them more often and they are more important for your overall strategy. Now, I won't say that the competitive edge is generated by the generic Majestics and the legendaries. I'm not saying it isn't, but the true backbone and playing the deck not to its fullest, but to its design path, to its design strategy, you need the full pitch set of the rares and the commons. So, to learn the game, let me just think real quick. Yeah, I think I've got it all covered. And so what my main point is that skullcap doesn't win you the matches. It's the knowledge. Just play the game, learn the game. And that's the way you get better at it. So yes, you can block an additional time with the skullcap for two versus an iron rod helm. But I've been beaten multiple times with people with iron rod helm, and I've been losing to myself not playing to the full outs of my deck versus the other player optimizing their turns and playing to the fullest of their turn. So putting all the numbers to it, it's 50 to try, 50 for these, that's the precon decks, and you can probably play the precon decks and put in an 84 box and play some more, expand the deck boxes that are pre-constructed with cards that you actually pull. And then what I already said, it's 600. I'll later added the 700 just to have a higher bound number to try for top 8. Although there are cheaper decks, quite certain of it. I believe Dorinthia can be played for less, especially with the braces not being required. And now a really good alternative in the common slot with the Galantry braces. If you're just playing the game, forget these names. It's kind of like a video for if you know the game, to show to a buddy. I'm making this video for a buddy of mine who was actually saying, yeah, I am getting into the game, it's crazy expensive and I don't even know if it's around for after 1 year. But you can play this game for a less dollar amount or euro amount and actually still have fun, and not saying compete in skirmishes in competitive environment for top 8, but in more casual environments, the army events, yeah, you can win. I know for a fact, because the top 10 player still doesn't have a skull cap and he beats me to death with Dorinthia multiple times in the army event. So the expected value of a box is higher than 80 euros. So if you tried it it doesn't fit you, or you just got wary of a certain matchup and the class you love just wasn't getting the attention and love you think it deserves, if it deserved, then the expected value of a box is higher than 80 euros. And it's quite literally possible that you can get out with a net positive amount. And if you accept the loss, then and just push it out on an eBay platform, a marketplace for the Netherlands, I'm pretty sure that you can push it off for a fair dollar amount still, because there's still, it's a growing game. Players are still getting involved. And yeah, that's what I had to say about what does it actually cost to play Flesh and Blood, from trying it to playing it to being competitive with it. Also, it's a non-rotating format, so you actually maybe can, after 1 or 2 years, still pick up a deck and just grab up some generic Majestics and some piece of equipment and still play the game. And if you get get a Cold Foil Legendary because you got a Cold First Edition box, then you can buy a complete deck and not be bothered with the cost, because that one pack bought you an entire competitive deck. Maybe that's what scares you about why are these insane prices. But the same version is also available for less than a euro. Yeah, if you want to play, be gracious in defeat and humble in victory, speak Dutch, leave a comment. We have a nice community where everybody's really involved in getting everybody better. And yeah, it's been repeated multiple times by myself, but also by other players. And I think that's the best part about Flesh and Blood. Everybody is really excited about the game, and they want to share this love and excitement with other people. See you next time.